All right, it's time to Ask the Doctor today, and Jillian and Dr. Jerome Williams here.
Good morning.
Good morning. It's great to see you.
Yeah, it's so good to be here in this festive season.
It is. Happy Thanksgiving to you.
Thank you.
All right, we have if you have questions, 741-9272, and I believe Beatrice is our first caller on the line. Beatrice, go ahead.
Yes, I have a question. My cats have fleas.
Can you hear?
And what's the best way to get rid of them, and does the cold kill the fleas?
No, the cold does not. Many folks have that disbelief that once it gets cold, you have to worry about fleas anymore.
But you do.
You get a hibernation state that goes on. So it's best to do everything you can to get rid of them during this season. But you must treat the fleas on both the pet and the environment. So if you got fleas with your cat in your house, treat your home also, as well as get a good product for your cat.
Can you recommend a good product, please?
Can you recommend
There are many good ones on the market. I would not want to name one specifically, but there are three or four very good ones from all the major manufacturers.
Okay. All right. Good luck, honey.
All right. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Shawarin is in Birmingham. Shawarin, you there?
Yes. My dog, in the beginning, she did have fleas, but we got rid of them. But then she started itching with a rash, and she started itching her fur off and stuff, and we tried to stop it, but there was nothing to do it. And then she caught fleas again. I was wondering, what is there to help get rid of the fleas and what, I guess, a skin irritation or rash?
So it sounds like they're having trouble getting rid of the fleas, and that's not unusual to get
skin
irritation.
You would probably have to treat the environment, spraying it or fogging it at least two or three times, take care of the fleas on the pet simultaneously. If you have multiple pets in your household, every pet must be treated. And I failed to tell the previous caller, fleas cause tapeworms. And tapeworms can be the cause of problems beyond getting rid of the fleas. So you need to treat the fleas as well as the tapeworms.
Because it leads to something very,
exactly.
It's a lot more serious then. Mm-hmm. Okay, so get rid of the fleas first and treat the environment. And
then
hopefully treat the tapeworm. Now, if the skin rash and everything has gotten to a point that you may need more treatment for that, right?
Yes, you might need to see a veterinarian. If you want to try something simple at home, you can go with Benadryl at the dosage of 1 milligram per pound, 2 to 3 times a day. You can give that a try for 2 or 3 days. If that does not do it, get them into your veterinary. If the flea infestation goes on long enough, you get an infection that must be treated with antibiotics.
Okay. So it may not be anything you can do with just the Benadryl or something like
right.
that. All right. Well, good luck, honey.
Thank you.
Thank you, dear. Let's go to Betsy. Betsy's in Northport. Hey, Betsy, good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, Betsy.
Yes. Hello. My question is, I have a dog that's about 14 years old, and she has cataracts. Mm. And I was wondering, will she eventually go completely blind, or can she always just, she's also got a hearing problem, but I, but anyway, she's the sweetest thing that ever was. And so, I just wonder, I mean, she's still happy as a lark, but.
In all likelihood, Betsy, she will go completely blind. Fortunately, we have 3 outstanding veterinary ophthalmologists in this city. So surgery can be done to restore the sight if she loses it. Now, getting another pet with her at this age and stage, you can have a seeing eye dog for her. So now may be the time to consider adding another pet to your
so
household.
So she'll just follow the other dog
yes.
around?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I keep her in the house, so therefore, you know, I don't let her go out just to do her thing and then come back.
Well, you might want to have your veterinarian get an appointment with one of the ophthalmologists to have her evaluated at this stage.
Uh-huh. Okay, well, I live in Northport, so he could get in touch with someone in...
He could, or he can call my office if he doesn't have their numbers available.
Dr. Williams works directly with some folks that he recommends that can do that kind of stuff, at least just do an evaluation.
Exactly.
Okay, how can I get your number?
I'm at 326-8080. That's 205-326-8080.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right, honey, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Let's go to Louise. Louise is in Montevallo. Louise, good morning.
Good morning. I have a Chihuahua about 6 years old, and he's had real bad allergy. And my vet recommended children Benadryl, but it hasn't done anything to really help him. And he sneezes.
Sneezes?
So this is sneezing, yes. Not scratching, right?
Yeah, right, right.
He doesn't scratch with it much, but okay. He sneezes a lot.
Okay.
It sounds like you're at the case where you're going to need to see a veterinary dermatologist, allergist. And we have a great one in the Birmingham area, in Dr. Hubbard. So I would suggest having your veterinarian get an appointment with her and have her do the evaluation. Okay. It sounds like something beyond the scope that normal general practitioners like myself would be able to handle.
Okay, thank you very much.
All right, hon. All right. Hey, as we wrap up, some important reminders for folks about Thanksgiving and sharing some of those leftovers.
This time of year, we often see dogs in with pancreatitis due to eating people's food. Mm. The other thing that we have often is pets being fed bones that cause problems. So I know you want to give them a nice little treat, but they're there begging and you want to reward them, but use caution in that.
Because you're not a doctor that says don't ever give them
right.
the bone, but certain ones are not good for them,
exactly.
right? The smaller ones?
If they're not used to them. Mm-hmm. And then they will continue to eat them as long as you feed them.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can get an impaction.
So just be careful. And
absolutely.
All right. You just don't believe what Buddy will eat.
I know. I know.
All right. Thank you so much. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
All right. Now.